Hello everybody, feel very welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to see how to launch and play Last Day on Earth on your PC. From now you can display it on screen. It takes almost no time to efficiently download and install Last Day on Earth and enjoy this game on a Windows computer with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to get started we need to open our favorite browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, simply because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We landed at this point on our site of Usitility, where we have a nice in-depth demonstration on the way to download and install Last Day on Earth on personal computer. We scroll lower a bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we reach the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to enjoy the game Last Day on Earth on our PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of pros of preferring this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Now we are ready to proceed to download the Last Day on Earth by simply clicking on the button Download Last Day on Earth on PC that you can visualize here in green color. The step is clicking on that button. And the download step starts and ends immediately. Voila! This is the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the executable file. Okay, so we need to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the internet browser to see the installation software better. The installer is uncomplicated. It consists of a couple of options: install and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path genuinely does. We only simply click on it. So we realize that we have here the path where in fact the emulator will be put in. If we have to change for better this folder, we have got to click on this browse option, and now we decide on another folder and install the emulator wherever we want. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. Then, I click on back. And I just click install. Now, prior to starting the installation of this emulator, it is possible that it'll offer us one or two application packages to add on the laptop. Since I do not wish to have any of these computer software, I simply press many times on the reject option. Now, there it is. The setup starts and it is going to continue together with the download of all these MB which are represented on this computer screen. Once you save it on your computer, it is likely to be a little more or less megabytes. The download speed could go faster or at a lower speed, based on your type of access to the web and according to the speed capacity of the emulator servers. Right now they're running really fast. The download has been completed, then now it continues on with the installation step. The setup requires a little bit more or less time based on the strength of your hard drive. The more powerful it actually is, the faster the setup time and or vice versa. If we combine the download and install step, it will take quite a while, so show patience. It is by now finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be launched successfully. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will advance to the right when it comes to the ending. The emulator can be started for the very first time. In reality, the emulator has been launched, there for the first time. So LD Store is instantly launched, which is actually a kind of Google Play. It's not the smartest solution to set up the video game, therefore I really don't suggest it, considering that generally the LD Store sets up an obsolete version of the game. Let me present to you the best way to set up the Android game working with the Google Play, therefore I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we need to do is to visit desktop by simply clicking this software icon that I'm indicating in green color. Before we continue, as you will notice, it has created a couple of icons right here on the computer desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player app icon is definitely the only one we're concerned about. Anytime we have to launch Last Day on Earth on our desktop or laptop, we double-click this particular software icon and as a result run the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon isn't about multiplayer or anything at all such as that. Not surprisingly, it's in software icon that we might quite likely never start using. Let's conduct the next step, which is actually a must, and that's to begin to browse the Google Play Store. To do this we will go there to System Apps, we click on. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can discover, the Google Play is started. Here we are required to sign in. At this moment, once we are on this page, we must begin doing this next phase that is imperative. So that we mouse click on sign in. Now it shows checking info. It can once in a while get stuck in checking info, and so it fails to continue. If so, you may try to connect to your account after a few hours, but it will surely most probably be sorted out. Now we can enter our email address and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. For instance, you make use of the same email you use at the moment in your YouTube account. So I will provide my info and I will go back after I have completed it. That's it, info entered. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us the twos. We must approve them all by simply clicking, I agree. Next, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked and this will generate a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can use this feature if you like. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play is started by default and instantly. In the event that the Google Play isn't presented by default and you have no idea how to start it yourself, I illustrate how to get it done. Firstly is to navigate to the emulator desktop by pressing this app icon marked in green color. At this moment we head to the system apps folder. And we click on the Play Store icon. Alright, we are here into Google Play. What we're going to accomplish right now is browse here to search for apps and games. And consequently we're going to search for Last Day on Earth. So there we have it, we can choose the first result. There we come with the game. Let's click on there on the install choice that I'm just showing now in green color. And this will launch the installation. Straight away it will install the Android game. It could take quite some time or perhaps it could also be extremely fast. That all is determined on the connection to the internet. It has as of now completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this option that I am presenting in green, that allows you to use Last Day on Earth for the first time. We are currently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're going to mouse click on the fresh Last Day on Earth app icon that was generated. The game app is launched for the first time. There we get it. I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the volume of that emulator. It is here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This is actually the first one. We mouse click on this software icon which I am basically identifying in green color. And the monitor is maximized, having one border at the top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In case we need to enjoy the application in full screen, we select that software icon. And we might already be experiencing and enjoying the game in full screen function. To stop the 100% screen functionality, click the F11 key. And we'd already play in normal computer screen setting. At present, I am on the way to show you the computer keys mapping, which is really rather cool. That strategy we will likely be ready to utilize the game app a lot more easily. The very first thing is to mouse click this app icon. And there you will have the ability to make the recommended configurations. I'm going to let the normal settings, though if you choose to improve it, you may well do so with no problem. I consider this time to comment that once in a while, when starting the game app a dark screen occurs, if it is like that and you discover the black display and the emulator fails to initiate, I propose a doable solution. We would click here, to the cogwheel. In the emulator preferences, in the advanced option we have now numerous resolutions. The following is the image resolution we have now decided on automatically and we must choose any of these additional graphic resolutions, for example this one listed below. We choose it and then click on save. It will require us to reboot your emulator and right after rebooted, probably the emulator will start up and the black display screen will vanish entirely. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is fully in our language. Once in a while it happens that the emulator is presented in the erroneous language, for instance, in Japanese. And consequently to place it in the right language we go there to the cogwheel. And there within many other settings, we just click on the language drop down. We may very well go with the language we prefer, Italian, Japanese, and so forth. Once the language is decided, we could save, the emulator would restart, and the game app, the next time we start it, would of course be in the specified language. At this moment, you can find another detail that we have to take into account, and it's that we will get an email telling that a completely new equipment has been connected with our Google account. It definitely will question us if we are the people who have connected that electronic device. Of course, we ought not get worried, considering the fact that emulator is acting as in Google Android device. And to determine which device is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Therefore we browse here to the model option. And now we discover that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for the video user demo. I hope you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was informative. In this case, bring it a great thumb up, subscribe to our channel, and any remarks, questions or ideas, let them in the comment field below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel. I conduct live streams every once in a while. You have it listed below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click on any of those videos which are usually appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the following online videos. Bye.